Oh my god. Oh no, I'm flying perfectly too. There's no damage on the flight model. Even though I collided with him. Oh my god. Who says this thing isn't OP? What's going on, guys? Today I'm flying out the F7F1 tire cap. We're up against the Japanese. I've actually been on the Japanese team against the Tire Cats. I was flying the A675, and it's just unfair. It really is. Even though in the A675 you can outmaneuver the Tire Cats, you just can't deal with the speed. They're so fast. And when you get everyone into a little furball, which tends to happen quite often on these Pacific maps, it's just a horrible furball of death if you're on the Japanese team. You can outmaneuver one or two Tire Cats. Once you get a whole slew of them together, it's unreal. I dive on that zero, but I just can't connect with him. You see, look at the speed of this thing. It's unreal. I nearly got to 900 kilometers an hour. I'm just gonna zoom climb out here. Try to create some separation, and then get back in the fight. I don't know if you noticed, but all of the zeros are all in one little area of the map. This is what tends to happen on these specific maps against Tiger Cats. And I believe we have some Bear Cats and Mustangs. So almost all the American aircraft in this particular game are boom and zoom aircraft. I think there's one premium Spitfire, but I could be mistaken. Here, the Zero comes up to try to meet me. I shred him, light him up. This one comes in, tries to avoid my shots. I only get a spark, no hits. The first Zero is down. He finally burned up. You can see more Tiger Cats, and I've even got one of those twin Mustangs. You don't see too many of those F-82s. I've heard they got buffed in the 1.43 patch, but I haven't tried it yet. This guy thinks he can get past me. Let's take a burst of him. Light him up. I didn't even have to zoom on that one. That was just an easy kill. He's going head on with that Corsair. Corsair smartly avoids. He knows that A675 is just trying to get into a head on. I take somebody with him. So the Corsair dodges his attack and lets him burn up. A675. They're everywhere, actually. He's on fire. Take a burst of him. He's still on fire. And here I'm actually a little nervous because I'm kind of in the swarm. The Tiger Cat's incredibly fast, but it's not much of a turner. It can outturn an A675. Or A6M3, like most of the planes are in this match. The Japanese did have a Kai 84 or two, but they just weren't enough of those to deal with the speed of the Tiger Cats. This guy stalls out, and I shredded him. That's kill number three. As I turn around, you look behind me, you can see all the aircraft are all in one little confined spot on this map, just over the island. Just one furball of death. I actually feel bad for the Japanese, because it's just not fair to fight against these Tiger Cats. It just isn't fair, not even close. Oh, got a hit. No critical damage, though. It probably has something to do with the fact that I'm still using the default ammo. I haven't unlocked any of the weapons upgrades yet. I'm still rocking the default ammo, which tends to have a lot of ball rounds, which are pretty much useless. I'm looking forward to getting those upgrades. No, I'm not going to be able to catch this guy. The Tiger Cat's too fast, too heavy to be able to pull up and get that zero. Thankfully, I got my teammates back there to help. Look at them all. Oh my god. Look at them all swarming. There's a Spitfire back there. Oh my god. It's like one versus like 10 of us. That's not fair. He's stalling out. Yeah, he's toast. Oh my god. And that's the match. It's one of the most ridiculous matches I've ever been in. It just everyone gets into one little small spot of the map and just rip apart the team. Yeah, best teamwork I've ever seen. I'm not sure if it was the best, but it's one of the best. There was no kill stealing, which was shocking to me, because usually when you get everyone in a small spot or small space, everybody starts taking one of those kills, trying to get those extra credits. Wow. And like I said, flying the Japanese against the Tiger Cat just isn't fair. Got 3 kills. With premium, I got 7,700 vehicle research points, which is helping me get that B-57. You see, I got a handful of little awards. Nothing too crazy. I did unlock the engine upgrade. I'm definitely making some headway there with the research of the upgrades. Anyway, it's on to match 2. This time we got up-tiered a little bit. 5.3 is the battle rating of the Tiger Cat. And in this match, we actually got up-tiered so that we're flying against planes that are as high as 6.3 for battle rating. So you can see we've got some P-80s on our team. Those are the early jets, if in case you didn't know. And we're against N1Ks, J7W1s, and Kai-84s. All very good aircraft, but still, against the Tiger Cat, they just can't cut the mustard. First shot goes into that N1K. I critical his tail, but he doesn't go down. Here's that new J7W1. I don't think he even sees me. Now he does. He's trying to turn, but it's too late. Put some shots into him. On to the next. There's a lot of these new J7W1s. The first one goes down. That N1K is still up, though. I'm trying to get up to this guy and get him while he's stalling out. First shot's missed. Little shot's missed. There. Take off his right wing and then knock out his pilot. That's 2 down. There's a Kai-84 over here. And J7W1 down below. We'll head on with the Kai-84. Not a good idea because he's got 30mm cannons. Unfortunately, neither one of us is a particularly good shot in this head-on. Call him out for my teammates to come help. N1K behind me. Kai-84 down below. And a J7W1 down there as well. N1K isn't a threat, so I'm going to go back. Try to get on either the Kai-84 or the J7W1. Unfortunately, the poor guy, poor Fuckle, if he has a Kai-84 on him, take a couple of shots. I just can't get my guns in front of him far enough to lead the shots, and I only got a hit on him. Wasn't able to do critical damage. I want to get out of here. I can actually hear the guy's engine behind me, so I know I'm a little too close for comfort. So I drop my nose and get the hell out of here. Get away from some of those 30mm cannons. Go up, I still see a whole bunch of N1Ks and J7W1s, as well as a Kai-84 back there. Flip it around into a loop. So the N1K, J7W1 down here. Lost him in the radar, but I'll be on him soon. There he is. I'm zooming. Take a couple of shots, missed. There, got him. Critical. And he's lost his wing. He's in trouble. And I get the kill stolen. Son of a bitch. Oh man, I hated that too, because I really wanted that kill. I hate when they get such an obvious kill steal on you. That guy was clearly dead. I'm trying to cover you, buddy. He's done. Myself and the Bearcat pilot, looks like we could combine and get him. Glory K. N1K, there's J7W1 on my left. Unfortunately, I don't have enough speed to get up and get this guy. Just a little too fast in the dive. Just can't quite get to him. So I'm gonna dive out of here. Let these other guys take care of him. I really want to get up and get some speed. But then I see that G7W1 has re-entered the fight, and I want to get over there and get my teammates a hand. 2 versus 2, now it's 2 versus 1. I don't like these odds. Now it's 2 versus 2, and now that I'm back in here. The N1K goes into a shallow dive, and now he's zooming away, and I can't. I just can't keep up with that. I can't handle those kinds of maneuvers in this thing. Unfortunately, this means that Bearcat pilot's all by himself against two. That's not good. I'm coming, dude. Yeah, I'm coming. The N1K is all over him. I feel bad, honestly. I get to him just after my teammate gets killed. Bearcat's down. At least just the G7W1. I'm thinking this is the last guy on their team, so I don't mind going head-on, trading one for one. I figured I'm gonna get ripped apart by that 30mm cannon. I take him, he takes me. I fear that's a fair trade. That's my third kill in this game. However, as it turns out, he's not the last guy. The last guy you can see on the bottom right-hand corner on the scoreboard. That's the first guy that I shot in this match. He didn't die. Remember, there was an N1K that I shot in the tail. Critical to his tail, but that was it. He didn't go down. He ended up dragging out the match for like 5 more minutes or 10 more minutes. But I decided to edit all that out. It was kind of boring watching the guy fly around. Basically, what happened is he ended up shooting down some landing craft at the very end of the match. Unfortunately for him, he ended up getting shot down by some landing craft. And of course, because it's the landing craft, I don't get a kill assist or anything like that, so that's that. Anyway, I got 4 kills, and with a premium account, I got over 8,000 vehicle research points. Getting a little bit closer to getting that B-57. Anyway, guys, thanks for watching. Leave a comment in the section below. And if you're new to the channel, subscribe. Take care, guys.